where judges received telephone calls, where courts were held at night. We do not want to go there. On the matter of IEBC, let me say, on the matter of IEBC, the recommendations that I have read say that political parties participate in the appointment of commissioners to IEBC. My brother Raila Odinga is good at football, so let me try to ask, how fair will be a league where the referee is appointed by teams, and not all the teams, some teams? How fair will this league be? If you persuade me that you will end up with a fair game, fine. That's what I'm saying. So if you tell me it is okay for some players, for some teams, not all the teams participating, to appoint the referee, if that's what we are saying, I have my reservations. And I need to be persuaded, like many other Kenyans, that that is fair. On the third issue, you have had me, I have had you. And I think that is good progress. It's good progress. You've had me, and I have had you. You think it's fair? I have a different opinion. Maybe we will find a meeting ground somewhere. The third issue, Your Excellency, is the independence of our police force. The 2010 Constitution was very clear that the police must act independently of any politicians, whether they are in government or in the opposition. To recommend that we will have a police council chaired by a CS is actually a derogation from the independence of the police. And I want to ask you, we must be careful on where we are going. Today, you may have the latitude to do what you think will be right as per you. Tomorrow, the shoe will be on the other leg. On matters to do with devolution, I agree that the increase to 35% is progressive, and that we must devolve more resources to counties. But accompanying the increase of resources to 35%, we must also ensure that the Senate has the necessary constitutional power to ensure that those resources are available and they are used properly. To recommend that the Senate cannot continue to have the constitutional mandate to discuss the division of revenue is actually a downgrade of the Senate. In my respectful submission, with additional resources, and with some members of Parliament now being members of the Executive because of the appointment of some members of Parliament as members of the Executive, in fact, the recommendation should not be a downgrade of the Senate, it should be an upgrade of the Senate to the upper house. And in any case, so that I conclude, in any case, we are now saying women And the participation of women in our governance doesn't make us weaker, it makes us stronger. It doesn't make us lesser, it makes us greater. If we are saying in the proposal that women now go to the Senate, and you are saying that when women go to the Senate, they are going to a Senate which has been downgraded, which has no responsibility on matters of resource allocation. Are you enhancing the participation of women, or are you downgrading the participation of women? I mean, we are having a frank and honest conversation, good people, and it's good for us to listen to one another. So if we are saying women who today are sitting in the National Assembly, where resources are being discussed, if we take them from the forum where resources are being discussed and take them to a downgraded Senate, we are making the participation of women nominal. The participation of women should be substantive, in my respectful submission. And finally, Your Excellency, I know my brother Bishop Oginde has said there are hustlers here and they should stop the hustling, and they are the reggae people and they should stop the reggae. I don't know about the reggae, maybe I can talk about the hustlers. But let me say the following. The real elephant in this whole conversation is what was identified as the winner take all, and the inclusivity question. Now, Professor Adam Solow, I have confessed I'm a scientist and I'm a bit slow. I want you to explain to me in this proposal. You have said that in this proposal, we will have the president with his running mate, deputy president. They will win, or we have candidates, they will win an election. And then the president will appoint the prime minister and the two deputies from the winning coalition. And then we will have the runner-up being the leader of opposition. Now, no problem, it doesn't matter who it is. I have no problem. You know, let us not personalize, there is no problem. Now, the question I am asking myself, have we sorted out the winner-take-all question? Yes. Oh, is that so?
Yes.
So, the president from his side, like for example here, President Uhuru Kenyatta, I am here, Kimunya is the prime minister because he's the leader of majority. We have Jimmy Angwenyi, who is our deputy as a deputy prime minister, and maybe Maoka Maore as one of the deputies. So what happens to the whole NASA brigade together with Musalia and all these other people? I mean, and I'm not saying anything. I'm just saying I want to be persuaded. And forgive me if I am slow. Forgive me. There are so many Kenyans who are in my category. Are we together? Finally, on this inclusivity question, it is my humble submission that as we discuss inclusivity around us, the leaders, we must have a candid, open discussion on inclusivity about the millions of Kenyans locked out by poverty and employment. We must discuss how they are going to be part of the Kenyan society. That discussion we must have. And I want to thank the young man, very good, the bright, intelligent young man from Kitale, because he said that we should not bring 16th century technology. And I am sure he was referring to the wheelbarrow. And possibly he was referring to me and this wheelbarrow. Sindio? Good. Now, the question I want to ask us, how come in the 21st century, a 16th century tool called the wheelbarrow, millions of citizens in the 21st century are still dependent on the wheelbarrow and mokokoteni? That is the discussion we need to have. Yes. That is the discussion we need to have. And that discussion is a discussion that involves millions of Kenyans. Millions of Kenyans. Let me then say, as I conclude, that the Honorable Kalonzo Musyoka, I am finishing. You know, I speak for millions of hustlers, so just give me a minute. Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. Thank you very much. So, Bishop Oginde said that the hustlers must stop the hustling. I have heard leaders here say that as we discuss this conversation, we must not have an us versus them. I have also heard leaders here say we must never have a conversation and a contest about the poor and the rich. We must never go there. And I believe we must never go there. But I want to remind you, good people, Abraham Lincoln, the 17th President of the United States of America, said, things may come to those who wait, but only things left by those who hustle. That is Abraham Lincoln. He was never talking about the rich and the poor. He was talking about the people who wake up early, the people who sleep late, the people who work hard, and that is the society we need to build. It is now my humble pleasure, ladies and gentlemen, to ask His Excellency the President of Kenya to make his remarks, and thank you very much for listening to me. Asanteni sana.
Thank you very much. Thank you. Thank you very much. Asante sana. Asante sana. Fellow leaders gathered at this historic constitutional place of Bomas, and it is historic because many a time, as has been said, we have gathered here to discuss constitutional issues. Mi nawasalimia nyote na nawashukuru kwanza kwa risala za birthday siku ya leo na nasema asante.